Please turn off all cell phones and rise for a moment of silence and pledge the flag. Okay, we've got a lot of presentations here today. I'd like to invite up the county. Roll call first, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Monisic?
Here.
Turnbull?
Here.
Amo?
Here.
Anagnostakis?
Present.
Benton?
Here.
Berkman?
Here.
Benelli?
Here.
Cantorino?
Here.
Cheney?
Here.
Dillard?
Here.
DeSalvo?
Present.
Ekis?
Here.
Fagion?
Here.
Hines?
Here.
Chemnitz?
Here.
Kulisek?
Here.
Paduk?
Here.
Riskevich?
Here.
Sullivan?
Here.
Biro?
Here.
Reshin?
Here.
21 present.
Okay, I'd like to invite up the county exec to do these presentations with me, and then when we get to the Senior Citizen Awards, Kevin Hines, and I've got it. Okay, Annie, relax, we're just starting here. Okay, Annie Rabbit, County Clerk, to come up for the first presentations for Terry Tragis, Mary Long, and Mary Ann Bertoff.
I know everybody has a busy and a long day, but we are very appreciative to taking a few minutes and acknowledging some great workers that we've had here in the county. And I think of all the county employees as great people, but I'm fortunate enough at the county clerk's office to have some of the best. So I don't want to miss by saying who's first and who's last, but these are three women who I think are still excited to come to work. And all of us who have a job know there's a lot of days you're not so excited. And so you do your job with respect, and the people appreciate all your hard work. But these are three women that probably half the county doesn't know. But the county, the part of the county who knows them and knows that the work they do, take it and respect it. And we know that because of all the letters, emails, and notes telling us each and every day without these employees, the county couldn't function. So I'm gonna start off with Mary Ann. And it's kind of sad because Mary Ann's retiring. And if I can, most of you who know her, when you ask somebody when they're retiring, what do you plan on doing with the rest of your life? Most of us would say, relax. When I asked Mary Ann this question, she said, I'm gonna volunteer. So does that not really talk about the kind of person Mary Ann is? Because doing her job for the last 36 years, she deserves a break. And again, anybody who comes to DMV knows when it's stressful, the people that are standing there, they need help, but they really need the dignity that they deserve. And Mary Ann, without you, I don't know how this county's gonna survive, so thank you so much. And Marie, you gonna say a few words about her?
I got to know Mary Ann while I was at the Assembly and continued when I got into the county. And the 3 years I've spent in the county so far, I don't think there's a day that's gone by that I have not seen her smile or treat the customers with respect. And she has such a witty mind, and I'm gonna miss her a lot, but she may not leave because you'll all see come end of July, I have her taped and gagged in her office. I'm not gonna let her leave, because we're really losing somebody who has such valuable information for 36 years. It's astonishing what she knows. So we'll hate to see you leave. And
yes, okay, thank you, Mary. Thank you. And we have Terry. And her real name is Teresa, but everybody calls her Terry. And if you ever come into the Newburgh DMV, the stress level there is always at the height. But Terry also addresses everything with smarts. She understands the dignity in which you show people, but she also knows the issues. And Terry's had a tough life. She had a husband who was very sick. She lost him last year. She has two children. She has worked here for the county for over 30 years. And let me tell you something, Newburgh is so very fortunate to have Terry work up there in the motor vehicle, and she's a lovely woman to work with, and she too shows excitement every day. So thank you, Terry.
In the short time, it's been a pleasure working with Terry too. She's a very hard worker. She's always helping the ladies out, or she's doing something in the office, but she's never sitting idle. So 30 years is an accomplishment, and you should be very proud of it. And I'd hate to lose you, so don't even tell me you're gonna retire.
Okay. And on the record side, again, it's the side in which the Perry Building you reside in, and the average bear who comes in there has issues, and they're serious issues, and most of the time, people don't have an attorney with them. And we tell them, we're not lawyers, we cannot direct you in the legal manner, but we will give you the best information we can. And without Mary Long, half that information would not evenly go out to the correct way. We know how popular Mary is, because when the banks and lawyers call, they don't ask if Annie Rabbit's in, they ask if Mary Long's in. So she takes the lead in the record side, and also an employee of 30 years who the county really could not function in the manner it has without your knowledge that you brought to the county. So thank you, Mary.
Mary has such an abundance of knowledge at the county clerk's office. I don't think there's a day that goes by that she's not called upon to offer some sort of assistance. And in her 30 years, she has had the unique opportunity to see so many new technologies and new procedures implemented that she always faces it with patience and kindness and willingness to help. So I just want to congratulate you, Mary, on your 30 years. We're very lucky to have you. And you're not retiring.
Terry and Mary, thank you very much for the job you do for the county. It's people like you that are the backbone that keep this county going each and every day. Mary Ann, what am I going to do when I go to DMV? You know? I'm like a deer in the headlights when I get in here, I'll tell you.
I left your name with
something. All right, as long as you got me covered. I might have to bring you back on retainer or something. Yeah? We got a certificate for you, Mary Ann. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Annie. Got the whole crew here today. Great job, ladies.
I think a month ago I showed up at the DMV in Newburgh with the FBI. Obviously the fruits of their work came in yesterday, but everybody was wondering what was going on. Thank you for all your cooperation.
Okay, is Anne Marie here? For the recipients, and Kevin, you're going to come down to? Anne Marie, are you going to give a synopsis of what each award is for and why they received it?
Thank you. May is Older Americans Month, and we celebrate two people that have gone above and beyond to really make the lives of the older adults in our community better. So one of the people, Bessie Kolacheski, is not able to be with us today. I think she's on vacation. But the other one, our senior of the year, is Pete Rogers with his lovely wife, and you should come down too, because you really allow him to do all of the work that he does. She did tell me she was happy sometimes when you leave the house, so I have to tell you that. I actually thought Pete was an employee because Pete works so hard every single day. He is at the Cornwall Senior Center, and he does a variety of things. Nothing is too menial. He takes the garbage out. He brings a smile to somebody. Whatever we ask him to do, he does. And he does it with a smile and really, really brightens the place up. And people say that one of the reasons they like to come to that senior center is because of you. So, Pete, I can't thank you enough for everything that you do. Kevin Monahan, do you want to say a couple of words? Kevin is the director. No, you don't? Okay. Okay, and that's fine. You don't even have to. But please come up. And again, thank you so much for allowing us to share him with us.
Hello and goodbye. Thank you. You have better things to do with your time.
Mr. Rogers, I represent Cornwall, and I know you're a resident of Landmark Drive, and Landmark Drive is a 55 and over community in Cornwall, and I assume you moved to Cornwall because of Landmark Drive, because I saw your resume where they indicated you moved from Sullivan County, where you also were a tremendous volunteer. I know you were in the Army. I know that you drove, I think for 17 years, senior citizens to doctor's appointments. And then when you moved to Cornwall, I think in 2013, you jumped right in as a volunteer here in Orange County. So anybody from Sullivan County who wants to move to Orange County, please do that and follow Mr. Rogers. This is not the first time I've been able to talk on behalf of the senior citizens in Cornwall. My buddy Tom Fagione knows that Cornwall is well known for their football, because he's from Port Jervis. But we're also well known for our senior citizens, our fire department, our ambulance corps. And I know Bessie, who's not coming, she was a volunteer at the Cornwall Hospital as well. So thank you for all your service, and keep up the good work.
Going to do all the hard work. I just repeat, we had a lot of fun a couple of weeks ago at the Big Wheels. The legislature likes these proclamations, so and then a lot of words, but we had a lot of fun at the senior center, and your colleagues were, as Anne-Marie said, very happy to have you there, and you have a good sense of humor, so no matter how difficult the days are, you always make it pass very easily, so I'm honored to be here. Steve, you want to say a few words?
Congratulations, Pete. Cornwall's also known for its braggers, I guess, right? Thanks for all you do. This is a big award in Orange County. We're always very proud of all the work that the seniors do, and to be named this is a real prestigious honor. Thank you very much.
I lie so gracefully. Yes, Anne-Marie, this is a proclamation for the outstanding accomplishment.
Bessie isn't here, but I think Bessie is a wonderful example of, you know, how old would you be if you didn't know how old you are? Bessie is 95. She has been volunteering for 30 years. She's still a volunteer. And if you saw her, you would never think that she was 95. So I'm going to take this and give this to her. I know it's going to mean a great deal to her. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Kevin, you want to say anything?
Just that she's also from Cornwall.
And now we also have somebody that has been with us for quite a while, Anna Aponte. This is her 25-year pin. However, she's been with us since 1989. She actually started out part-time. She's always worked in our senior dining program, and you know, I think you can certainly speak of all of the changes that have taken place. I think you were really in it at the very early beginning, and you know, just how the program has grown and the value of the program. You are a big part of that. She has moved her way up the ranks. She is now one of the site managers, and we really couldn't do it without you. I can't thank you enough for all of the dedication that you have to the seniors of this county. So thank you. Kevin is her supervisor.
So I just wanted to say, there's no way I could do anything that I do without your help. So, you know, I started only 2 years ago, and you kind of held me by the hand as I got going. And I just want to thank you for all the help you've given me and all the help you've given the seniors and all the help you've given Orange County. Thank you, man. I know what you're doing in the village of Montgomery with the nutrition site, and very proud. You're not leaving, though, right?
Not yet.
Checking.
If that would work, because we're supposed to be honoring her. She's taking pictures.
I know, exactly. Yeah.
Thank you for, it's an honor, unexpected. All the years, they went fast. I do love what I do, and I'm very proud to be a county worker. So, happy to tell people that I work for the county, because I think it's a great job. That's why I'm staying. I'm not leaving yet.
Okay, finally we have James Burpo, Jim and Jeanette, you want to come up with your son? Huge honor. Who wants to give us a little analysis or synopsis of the award?
I think since we have one of NYPD's other finest with you, can I put your boss on the spot or your colleague?
Oh, your boss with you? Oh, great. Inspector Stevenson, you want to tell us a little bit about James? What he's done down there?
Florida resident.
Happy to have you. Oh, you're from Florida?
Resident. Yeah. So, hi, good evening. I did not come with a prepared speech, but I would not have driven 70 miles from the city had it not been for how special James is to me and to the people in the city that we serve. You know, I've been in the police department for 21 years, and I have the distinct pleasure of supervising many officers throughout the years. Every year, the police department graduate thousands and hundreds of new officers. While I was the precinct commander in the 3-0 precinct, I had the pleasure and honor to have James as one of my new guys. And right away, I recognized how special he was. You know, and over the years, once I've gotten to know Jim and his wife, I came to realize that he was not just special because he's a great cop, but he's special because he's a good person. And Jim, you guys did a great job with little Jim here, and he's a firecracker. Don't let his size fool you. I've seen him in the streets, and you know, the bad guys do pay. So I just want to thank Jim for the work that he's done in the city. We've had some record-breaking years in reducing crime in the West Harlem community where Jim and I serve. And you know, even though he's got a few years under his belt, he's going to be a fine officer. He's contributing greatly to the great hard work that we're doing in the city, and he has a bright future. Jim was just recognized as the Cop of the Year, which is a distinct honor when you're going up against several officers who've done the tremendous work that, you know, these guys do in the city. So, Jim, I just want to congratulate you for the work that you do. And while he's not doing the work here in Orange County, he is keeping the bad guys in the city where they belong, in jail. So rest assured that he's doing the service for you guys in Orange County. So congratulations and thank you.
I had the opportunity of speaking with Jim a couple times. It's kind of funny because I call your dad Jimmy, so it's kind of hard to have to call you now, Jim. He's had some, I don't know if you're going to go into some of the gory details, but you've been dealing with some serious criminals and serious crimes, and Inspector alluded to. I've talked to both of you on some of the stuff that you've done. You don't get cop of the year in the biggest police department in the world, over 50,000 men and women. It's not an easy thing. So we are very impressed, and we're proud to have you guys both calling Orange County your home. So, Chairman?
Thank you, and thank you again for coming up. We know what his father does in IT for the County of Orange as well as General Services, and we're very pleased with his performance, and as I'm sure you are with his in New York City. And I can't congratulate you enough on this honor. We're happy to have you here. I know you went on the Yankee Mets bus trip with us last year, and we got off at Citi Field. There was a tree over there, and he was sitting by the tree, and nobody wanted to go near him. You know, that guy's like a mongoose, they said. Very quiet, but tough package. You want to say anything, Jim?
Just that we're incredibly proud of him. That's all. It's his day, so.
You want to say anything?
Absolutely.
Just say thank you.
Give some of the stories.
First off, I'd like to say, let's go menacing football. That's the first one. I'd like to thank the Sheriff's Department, also brothers and sisters over there. They're always keeping it safe out here. Appreciate that. I'm proud to live in Orange County. It's where I call home. I have future plans to one day, you know, follow this man's footsteps and do something along the lines in Orange County, as well as my father. So I'd love to use what I learned in New York City with the police department to incorporate that with the wonderful area that I live. I'd like to thank the inspector, Rael Stevenson, for giving me a chance when I first came to 3-0 and allowing an unknown kid to prosper and go forth. And I'd like to thank my kids and my wife for, you know, sticking up with me when I get home at 5:30 in the morning and, you know, throw bagel bites or something in the oven. So I'd just like to thank all you guys. This is a tremendous honor, and I really appreciate everything you do, and I'm ready for the next Mets game. Thank you.
We have Dairy Month. Paul Raskevich coming down to give us a little overview. Is Lucy here?
Yeah.
Not here?
They're out front. Are they all out front? They're coming. Yeah. Jeff, you sampled it with me, right? You're good, right? You sampled it.
So entering is the Orange County Dairy Court. And Sydney, our newly crowned Dairy Princess, has a few things to say about the dairy industry here in Orange County.
Hi, my name is Sydney Parkin, and I'm the 2016-2017 Orange County Dairy Princess. The Dairy Princess program is through the ADADC. We go around promoting the dairy industry. I would like to thank you all for your continued support of the dairy industry in Orange County. My court and I have been very, very busy. We have gone to races and given out chocolate milk to the racers to refuel. We actually did a school program where we went to a local farm and we actually toured the farm with the kids. I've gone to Delaware County and actually went to the pageant and talked to the new princess and encouraged her. We're actually going to be at the Orange County Classic this Sunday, giving out chocolate milk again, which is a huge thing. June is Dairy Month, as you all know, so next time you have a cup of milk, a piece of cheese, or even ice cream on a hot day, don't forget to thank a farmer. Thank you.
Okay, we also have a proclamation here. I'm not going to read the whole thing because it's pretty long, but I'm sure you can find a good place to keep that. And I just want to thank all of you for coming today. June is always my favorite session because we always get samples of dairy products beforehand. I'm a little disappointed we didn't have cheese this year, but the punch was good. I had two of them. Everything you do, look, this is just one of the events that these ladies do throughout the year. They travel all over the county, all over the state, promoting the dairy industry and the agricultural industry as well. So, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Majority Leader Bonnison.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move to vote collectively on items numbers 1 through 26. I just want to see if anybody listens to me. Seriously. Seriously, 9 through 14, vote collectively. Just test.
Okay, if there are no objections, these items will be voted on collectively. Are there any referrals, withdrawals, or consents? Okay, we ready to go to the agenda? Okay. A is receive and file, agenda item number 1.
Legislators Bureau, Kulisek, Benton, and Hines. Resolution making a supplemental appropriation to the 2016 Orange County budget for the Orange County Real Property Tax Services Office pursuant to section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Yes, Minority Leader Turnbull.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This resolution represents the first step in cleaning up a mess. I'm all for cleaning up messes. I voted no in two committees, Ways and Means and Physical Services, requesting more information. I want to thank Mr. Chapman for getting that information to me. I think I'm going to change my vote to a yes, and I'm glad to see that we're processing this thing. It's hard to believe when the county, with all its resources, all its attorneys, and all its capable people, make mistakes that could potentially cost taxpayers millions of dollars. You got to be more careful, and I'm glad to see this one is being taken care of. Thank you.
April. Yes, let's hear Purdue.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I would agree with Matt wholeheartedly, and a big mistake. You know, what we're doing is we're paying a ransom. We own this property already. We're going to take $1.2 million taxpayer dollars out of the undesignated fund balance and give it to Mount Cove for plans that represent residential, that represent all the studies they did for their proposal was residential. We're not planning on doing any residential there. That's what their plan was. Apparently, we have a different plan, which is a much better plan, in my opinion. However, paying $1.2 million for stuff that we don't need, I will never support that, and I'm sure that the taxpayers, once they find out that we already own the property, which I would assume they know, and to pay 1.2 to get the rights back from a person who was originally purchasing the property from the county, we promised them water and sewer. Wow, they can't have water and sewer, so now we have to buy the property back when we still own it. There's something major wrong there. And talk about mistakes. This one is a huge mistake. And I find it pretty embarrassing. Thank you.
Yes, Legislator Anagostakis, then Benton.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Some of us weren't here when this original contract was formulated, voted on, and signed and executed by the last administration. So I take the words of my colleague, Mr. Paduka, seriously. I mean, it looks like it's some kind of a ransom to get out of this contract. But let's be honest about it. That contract was a travesty. That past administration blundered. I mean, I can't tell you how much they blundered and wasted the taxpayers' money. So we've already paid roughly $10 million, and now, yes, we do have to pay another $1.2 million. But what we're trying to do is get out of a terrible situation where we blundered and wasted taxpayer money. And what you learn, if nothing else, if you ever invest money, is when you make a mistake, you cut your losses short. And that's what we're trying to do here. We're trying to cut our losses short, recoup the property, turn around, get some money back for the taxpayers. So I don't like, any more than some of my other colleagues, that we have to pay money to get that back. I hate that. But I hate even more what was done in the past administration, and we need to correct that and move forward. It's the only way we're going to recoup some of that money back for the taxpayers. So I will be voting for this measure, and I commend the current administration for trying to move forward and correct a past error. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, I agree with the previous colleagues that said that they should support, and everyone should support this issue. I have to disagree with Mr. Paduk. Of course, in any real estate deal, when the contract is drawn up, the owner of the property owns the property till it's closed and the contract is fulfilled. So actually, we're not buying the property back, but we're actually paying Mountco for the rights that they have under that contract. So we're actually paying money to them to get their rights that they occupy with that contract. Otherwise, we couldn't do that. And everyone should support this. Thank you.
Thank you. Hearing Mr. Nagostakis speak, a few of us at the table, I think, were here when this was originally discussed, debated, and voted on. As I look back at it, I think, you know, no good deed goes unpunished. If you were here, you would have seen the hundreds of people, maybe even thousands of people that marched in the municipalities and the county saying, we bought homes next to Camp LaGuardia, the homeless shelters, get rid of it, buy it from the county. The pressure was enormous because people, in my opinion, found great deals when they bought houses near Camp LaGuardia and then looked out their backyard and saw Camp LaGuardia. No kidding. But the point is, they asked us to get rid of it, the pressure was on us, and we ended up doing what we thought was the right thing at the right time. Looking back at the contract, I can't disagree, but I think it's unfair to say, if you weren't here and you weren't in our shoes, to criticize the decision we made to buy the piece of property, to get rid of the piece of property, and to get rid of Camp LaGuardia.
Yes, Legislator Bureau.
Yes. As a resident of Chester, and the County of Orange first came about and announced that they were purchasing a property from the City of New York homeless shelter, I was thrilled. It took away a lot of our problems, took away a lot of our quality of life crimes. And we appreciated that. We didn't know what was going to happen. We didn't know there's going to be stagnation for the next 8 years. Now, 8 years forward, I am involved with the county and I'm very concerned about what happens there. We all agree it was a bad deal. And as was mentioned earlier, we do need to cut our losses. It's not gonna be a moneymaker. We're not even gonna get our money back, I don't think, on this whole process. But as County Executive Steve Newhouse said, we need to move forward on this in the state of the county address, and we are doing that. We're in a position now with the two towns, Town of Blooming Grove, Town of Chester, and a little bit with the Village of Chester too, are more than willing to work with the county with the zoning changes. And I fully support this, and I hope every legislator here does support this. We all agree it's a bad deal. Now is the time to make some changes and come out of this the best way we can.
I agree with that. when I voted to purchase the property many years ago. I don't regret that. I mean, it's one of the biggest scourges, public safety risks in the history of the county. And we did it to help that, those communities down there and the whole county. And the subsequent contract was not a good contract. Hindsight's 20/20. But what we're trying to do here today is correct that situation and make a bad contract just a little bit better. And if you don't vote for this today, we could be tied up for years. The county was not on the tax rolls before, and it's not on the tax rolls now. We're paying a pretty big bond on that. But at least this way, we have an opportunity to put that, get that land on the tax rolls and make it productive for the whole county. So I urge you to vote for this. Roll call.
Honessa?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis?
Yes.
Benton?
Yes.
Berkman?
No.
Brunelli?
Yes.
Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney?
Yes.
Dillard?
Yes.
DeSalvo?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Fagion?
Yes.
Hines?
Yes.
Chemnitz?
Yes.
Kulisic?
Yes.
Paduk?
No.
Ruskevich?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Bureau?
Yes.
Brescia?
Yes.
19 ayes, 2 noes.
Okay, number 2, a bond resolution requiring 2/3 vote.
Legislators Ruskevich, Turnbull, Benton, DeSalvo. Bond resolution dated June 2nd, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing acquisition of machinery and apparatus for construction and maintenance by the Department of Public Works, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $500,000, appropriating said amount, therefore, authorizing the issuance of 158,000 bonds of the county to finance a portion of said appropriation, and authorizing the expenditure of $342,000 expected to be received from the state of New York towards the cost thereof.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Nagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisic? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Brescia? 21 ayes.
Okay, number 3, also a bond resolution.
Legislators Anagnostakis, Turnbull, Amo, and Benton. Bond resolution dated June 2nd, 2016. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the construction of improvements to the Veterans Memorial Cemetery, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $1,200,000, appropriating $150,000, therefore, in addition to the $450,000 previously appropriated and $600,000 expected future appropriations, and authorizing the issuance of 150,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
The discussion, Legislator Anagnostakis and Legislator Berkman and Benelli.
Thank you again, Mr. Chairman. Just basically to restate some of the things that I'd said at committee, just to put things on record. I'm very thankful for the work that our commissioner is doing in this area for our veterans. That cemetery is certainly moving along, and the improvement and then the development of this particular parcel will give him more room for expansion. As he mentioned, I forgot the number, but it was a tremendous amount of burials that occurred there over the last year. I think he mentioned that this the cemetery that we have right now probably will be able to accommodate Orange County veterans for the next, I don't know, 20, 25, maybe even 30 years. But one thing I did mention at committees, and I want to restate again here for the record, there is some vacant land adjacent to that cemetery, and this county ought to start thinking and looking at potentially placing options on some of that land, because we may not be here 25 and 30 years from now, but there will be a shortage of land unless we take action today to look forward to the future of 50 and 80 years from now. So hopefully people can start thinking about optioning some of the vacant land next to it. But thank you, Commissioner, for the great work you do.
Okay, yeah, Legislator Cantorino mentioned that in committee as well, and I think John McCary is already on it.
Great.
Who was next? Jeff, and then Katie, and then.
This is one of the things the county got right with this investment. I think we're all proud of it, and it's quite beautiful out there and respectful. And if we made one, if we had to do it over again, the one thing I think I would have urged more strenuously would be to have more space, more acreage. Because we started out, I think it was 5 acres, then they immediately went to 10, and then we've already expanded beyond that. So I also agree that it's appropriate that we take care of future generations by getting more more land in that proximity. And please add my name as a sponsor.
Absolutely. Katie, all Democrats, all Republicans, and Michael? Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Actually, I was going to ask to be added as a sponsor, but I would also like to recognize Christian and his staff. At the meeting, the Ways and Means Committee meeting, he invited us to go out and see how the cemetery actually looked today. And I had the opportunity to stop by there on Memorial Day. And we've heard how this is probably the fastest growing cemetery in Orange County. And I have to tell you, there was a continuous stream of cars mid-afternoon on Memorial Day. They just kept coming, spent a few minutes, and left. The place looked absolutely beautiful. Thank you, Christian. It is something that we can all be proud of. And this is a resolution that each year we set aside and appropriate some money to continue to grow that cemetery. And I applaud this effort. Thank you.
I'm not so sure that a fast-growing cemetery is a good thing, but I also want to thank Christian Farrell. When he came before the committee, he really had his ducks in a row. All the information, you know, this is not as simple a thing, a cemetery, as you would think. You wouldn't think there would be any controversy at all, but he was well, you know, equipped to explain to us who is entitled as far as veterans and their spouses and the number, the ratio of direct burials to cremations. And you know, I was just thinking that, you know, with what's going on, we now use drones in warfare, we're headed towards robots. I'm not sure that sometime in the future we'll have a need for these cemeteries. That would be a great thing. But thanks a lot for your hard work, Mr. Barron.
Bill, you want to say something?
There we go, I do. I would also like to thank Mr. Christian because he had all the documentation and what we needed to understand where we were going with the expansion. This cemetery, during one of our committee meetings, I did make the recommendation, even though we talked about being 20 years out, to see if we could purchase more land. But usually when I say something, I usually delve into it, so I did go to the building inspector's office. I also went to the assessor's office, looked at some of the tax maps, and John did some.
He just left.
John McCary's here. I will get with him. There are parcels. There's a 5.7 acre parcel right next to it, and the developer has parcels in the back that are contiguous to it that may be able to purchase some of it. So this is a reality. And I think we should really go forward with this and look to the future now and secure additional properties. So work on it. I am working on it. And I think it'll come to fruition, Kristen.
Thank you. I just have to say that, you know, this didn't start out as rosy as we thought either, and it's turned out to be a great asset for the county. But I was at the groundbreaking ceremony, which was to be the original Veterans Cemetery at Orange County Airport, off East Kaisertown Road, and Roberta Murphy was chair, and then we couldn't do it because of the glidescope, I believe it is, that had to go in out there, or am I, glidescope? Yeah, so, you know, there's been a lot of things that have had to be corrected that ended up right in the end, so. Okay, roll call.
Yes.
Yes.
Bonasic?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis?
Yes.
Benton? Berkman, Benelli, Cantorino,
yes.
Cheney, Diller, DeSalvo, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia, 21 ayes.
Number four.
Legislators Benton and Turnbull, resolution authorizing the private sale and conveyance of certain county-owned lands acquired by reason of a failure to redeem said lands from a tax sale to Orange County, pursuant to section 10184 of the real property tax law and Orange County amended local law number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasic?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekus? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Brescia. 21 ayes.
Number six. Aye.
Legislators DeSalvo, Bonacek, Benton, and Kulisek. Resolution making a supplemental appropriation to the 2016 Orange County budget for the Orange County Attorney's Office pursuant to Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonacek. Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Benton. Berkman. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk. Riskevich. Sullivan. Vero. Bresha. 21 ayes.
Okay, now number six.
Legislators Berkman, DeSalvo, and Kulisek. Resolution authorizing the county executive to apply for, accept, appropriate, and implement a federal transit administration grant, the matching New York State Transit Grant, and a local county match for the Orange County Department of Planning, pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Yes. Yes, Chris Ickes, Barry Cheney, Paul Riskevich. Okay, roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo. Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk. Riskevich. Sullivan. Vero. Bresha. 21 ayes.
Okay, number seven.
Legislators Chemnitz and Bonacek. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Planning to apply for and accept grant funds from the Federal Transit Administration pursuant to Section 99-H of a General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Bresha. 21 ayes.
And number eight.
Legislators DeSalvo, Paduk, Riskevich, and Benelli. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature assuming lead agency status under a state Environmental Quality Review Act, SECRA, with respect to the communications tower in the town of Montgomery, classifying the action as unlisted and determining that the action will not have any significant adverse environmental impacts.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonacek.
Yes.
Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnostakis. Benton. Berkman. No. Benelli. Cantorino. Cheney. Dillard. DeSalvo. Ickes. Fagione. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Bresha. 20 ayes, 1 no.
Okay, resolutions 9 through 14. Roll call. Our court discussions? Discussion. Yes, Curly. Want to be added? Okay. Now roll call.
No, Mr. Chairman.
Yes. Oh, Chris.
Yeah. Over here. thank you. I am going to have to abstain from number 14 in the hopes that one day a member of my family will be able to take advantage of this program that's up and coming. I absolutely believe in it. It's a wonderful program, but I'm going to abstain for a possible conflict of interest. Thank you.
Okay, but you'll be yes on the rest?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, Jim. Cool, sir. You want to be added at all? Okay. All right, now roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Bresha? 21 ayes. One abstention on number 14.
Excuse me.
Okay, number 15.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Can I have my name added to all of them as well?
Yes. Number 15, do all legislators want to be on 15? Who was? Phil wants to be on? Everybody wants to be on 15, right? Helen Keller? No, I know that. But I'm jumping ahead to... Okay. Did I miss anybody? Phil was the last one we added, correct? Does anybody else want to be on 9 through 14? No. Are you on 15 or are you on 9 for 14?
All Dems on 9 through 14. Okay, we got it. All right, now 15. Does everybody want to be on 15?
Yes.
Okay. All Dems, all Republicans, and all Independents. Okay. All right. Any discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Padduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau Brescia. 21 ayes.
Did you come for that resolution? For that family that came in late? Are you here for that? No? Okay. I'm sorry. Okay, 16.
Legislators Benton, Cantorino, and Benelli. Resolution confirming the appointment of Karen E. Hablow as Commissioner of Finance for the Orange County for the County Executive pursuant to Section 5.01 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call. Your name added? Okay.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ickes? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Padduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Bureau? Brescia. 21 ayes.
Congratulations, Karen. I went through quick and easy, no comments. I tell you, that's good. Number 17.
Legislators Fagione, Benton, and Ickes. Resolution creating a voluntary separation agreement for all county, Orange County government employees.
Second.
Discussion? Yes, Rosie.
I'm on the PNC committee, and during that committee, at that committee meeting, we were handed information, a sheet of paper titled Voluntary Separation Overview. And I don't know about the rest of the committee, but I didn't get a chance to really study that sheet until I got home. And there were a couple of questions I had and a couple of concerns, and I just want to go over a couple of them. First of all, I asked for the breakage of last year's 10 to 20 bracket. As well as numbers on this year's 10 to 20 bracket. And we were not given those numbers, the savings amount, just for that bracket. And that's something that I think would need further study. And the reason why is because that is the lowest amount of savings that we would probably see, because it's the lowest salaries. And I think that actually really does need further study until we can decide if it's going to be worth it. Some of the wording in the resolution I think needs a second look. And also I'd like to point out that We're combining retirement, like a retirement incentive here, with the separation agreement. And they're two different things. And not only that, but when somebody, a staff member steps up and says, okay, I want to take the separation agreement, we're trying to get more bang for our buck by not filling that position, right, for at least part of the year. Which I could understand, but then we're doing desk audits on top of that. And the desk audit is revealing to us that that we need to change certain positions and maybe change the classification of the position, or in some areas that we actually have to add positions. So from what I see through that process is that the process of not filling those positions is indirectly manipulating the desk audit and the outcome. So it's not giving us a real true picture of what we need in terms of personnel in a specific department or what changes we have to make. I think that's probably the biggest concern, that and studying how much money we're possibly going to save by buying out a 10-year employee, for instance. And how is it affecting services, and how is it affecting the people who depend on those services? I would like to send this back for further study to the committee. And I don't know if everyone else has gotten this voluntary separation overview, but there's also, there's a, on the voluntary separation overview, it says that this, this deal is going to be given only to union contract employees, but yet in the resolution itself, it says it will be given to all county employees. And you know, I'd like to know what was the final outcome, because they're not the same. It's not the same verbiage. Another thing that needs further that needs to be changed is the way the scale goes is you have $15,000 going to staff members who have 30 and plus years in, and then $12,500 for 20 to 30. Okay, so is it 20 to 29, or and then 30 plus, or 20 to 30 and then 31 plus? And the same goes for the 10 to 20 bracket. So if you're 20 years or 30 years, you're kind of in between, and it's kind of, it's leaving it up to someone else to decide, and it's not clear. So that has to be cleaned up as well. So, you know, I see a lot of wording here that needs to be cleaned up, and I think that if we are going to go ahead with this, and you know, hopefully it will yield some savings to us, we want to make sure that we're doing it right, not offering something that could possibly be costing us money in administrative time.
Commissioner,
I'd like to make that motion.
Is there a second to the motion? Okay, this will be discussion on the motion. Commissioner, were all the employees of the county canvassed with this early retirement incentive?
This is a, may I come up?
Yeah, and is it a time-sensitive issue?
Thank you, Chairman. So this is the third year. The first year we did a true retirement incentive. Last year we did a voluntary separation agreement, which meant that you did not necessarily have to retire. You could just leave county service. What we did this year was really the same exact thing that we did last year. The only thing we did was change some of the schedules. Last year we had a 5 to 10 component. If you had 5 to 10 years of service, you would be able to separate. We removed that, given some of the considerations Roseanne Sullivan, Legislator Sullivan mentioned before. And what we did was moved it out to the longer term employees. The sheet that Legislator Sullivan was referencing was really an explanation of the savings of the last 2 years of incentives, which saved $8.5 million, I must add, and included 191 employees. This incentive does apply to all employees. The negotiating units of the CSCA agreed to it. We had to negotiate that with CSCA. Sabina Shapiro, president, is in the audience, I see. All the other negotiating units agreed to it as well, and it would impact all employees of the county. We think it's a great thing. We've really done a good amount of work in removing some of the long-term, longer-serving salaries in the county and replacing them with some entry levels. As I said before, the first savings of the first incentive, which had 130 employees roughly, was $5.8 million. Last year saved $5.3 million. The cost of the incentive was 2.5, so we subtract the 2.5 from the 11.1, that's how I came up with the 8.5 savings. We believe it's worked well for the last 2 years. We'd like to continue.
And might I suggest in the future, if any legislator, I don't think we should be asking 12 questions on the floor, or more, or even 4 or 5 questions on the floor. If you saw those questions that you wanted to ask or concerns, Roseanne, you should have called Commissioner Gross right afterwards. And if you didn't get the answers, I probably could have answered a lot of them. He probably could have answered them, a lot of those questions, in a half an hour's time. And if he didn't have the time, he could have done it in writing. It's not the time of the floor to ask these questions. If they weren't asked in committee, forward your questions to the legislative office. We'll get them to Commissioner Gross and try to get the answers you want. And then if you don't have the answers that you want, vote against it or try to send it back to committee at that point. But to answer a dozen questions here today is unreasonable. I mean, that's what the committee process is for.
That is your job as the chair to make sure that the answers are given. And
I will do that if the questions are asked.
And those questions were asked. I don't have questions today. I am pointing out to the rest of the legislature that these questions were asked, they were not answered, and they do deserve further study.
Then forward the questions to me.
Then forward the questions
to me.
You had
the floor. I'm going to go on to other legislators. You had the floor for a long time. Who was the next legislator to speak? What? Legislator Amo, then Legislator Berkman, then Legislator Turnbull.
Thank you. I'm going to vote for this, but I guess I really respect Commissioner Gross's analysis, and I believe he's doing the right thing. My problem with this is I've had a good amount of experience being involved in early retirement layoffs over my career with the state. In fact, I was fortunate enough to take a very nice early retirement package from the state myself, and it feels good if you're an employee. I think the question that I think comes up for me is the brain drain. I think it's important to do the early retirements and the separation agreements when you're in a real fiscal crisis, because you really need that money. I'm not sure we're in that state right now, and I think what happens is we end up losing some very talented people that we invested an awful lot of money in to learn their job well enough. And I've seen and have experienced that sometimes a negative impact on that is bad mistakes get made because people lack the experience. We might pay them less, but guess why? Because they don't have the experience. And I think that's the risk we have to be careful. So we may save X number of million dollars, but one lawsuit in a department can eat that up very quickly because somebody makes a bad mistake. That's just a danger. I'm going to vote for it because I believe that unlike Ms. Sullivan, I believe that Mr. Gross has vetted this and they thought this thing through, and I'm going to trust them on it. That's a concern I have, and I hope we think real hard about the brain drain that we do into our county if we want to think about this going forward.
Legislator Berkman.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I appreciate Mr. Gross's narrative, but I don't think I got a clear answer to what Ms. Sullivan's question was, which was, A, is it time sensitive, and also about the terminology of 20 years, 30 years, because they're in both columns, and other imprecise language. And this all addresses the direct motion on the floor, which is to send back to committee to clean it up.
Legislator Turnbull.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'll be supporting this amendment because, you know, this is not my area of expertise by any means, but I listened to Legislator Sullivan earlier try to explain to me what all the aspects of it were. And I think there's enough here to go back to get clarification, especially on the verbiage in the resolution. Now, I think Mr. Gross does a great job, but I totally disagree with the chairman's explanation that the questions should occur right there on the spot in committee when we see a resolution. I can't tell you how many times something comes before the committee, I see it for the first time, I take it home, I research it, I study it, and that generates the questions that I might have. So of course they're going to come up on the floor. That's not unusual. I think with a lot of the business that we do, something comes before a committee and it takes time for us to read it and to understand it. And sometimes the research is extensive. You know, I think Melissa will agree with me that in caucus, we rely on different members of the caucus for different areas of expertise that they may have. And so again, when we caucus and we go over the monthly agenda, sometimes that's when the questions are generated. You know, we're just trying to do our job here and do the right thing by the people of Orange County. It's that simple. And nobody should be criticized for trying to do that.
Well, I have a job to do to streamline this governmental process, and I don't have a problem with a few questions on the floor, but if those questions were thought about 3 weeks ago, they could have been asked in that 3 week
past
time.
Weeks
they could have been asked in that 3 week
listing
time period. Well, you're out of order. You're out of order. Legislator Anagnostakis.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I've been here 6 years, and so I understand things get heated sometimes, but we have to calm down and do the people's business. So back to this motion in front of us, and we have a motion and seconded to bring it back to committee. I do appreciate some of the things that Ms. Sullivan said. I think there is one problem that she pointed out. I'm going to ask our attorney for a legal opinion on that, and then I'm going to make a motion to move to make a correction on that, if I'm correct in what I'm thinking. And that motion will supersede, step ahead of the motion that we have to bring it back to committee, and then if we make a change to it, then we could decide whether we want to bring it back to committee or not. A question for our attorney, where it does say $10,000 for employees with 10 to 20 years of service and $12,500 for 20 to 30 years of service, I see a problem if an employee has exactly 20 years of service, he falls under both categories. If I'm correct in that, I would make a motion to change the second part to read $12,500 for 20 plus to 30 years of service. Am I correct in my analysis?
Yes, thank you, Ms. Nairn.
Okay, so
I appreciate it.
Thank you. So I'll make a motion to change that second clause to $12,500 for 20 plus to 30 years of service, and hope someone seconds that motion.
We can put another motion on the floor, even though there's a motion sent back to committee.
Yep.
Okay, discussion on that motion.
And so my point is, if we make that correction right now, that takes that off the table as a problem. Otherwise, if we move forward with this resolution, we would have a problem for that example of an employee with exactly 20 years of service.
And you have to fix the 30.
And also for the 30, you want to make a motion?
Fine. If you read the 30, it
just
already
that
has
one
it.
Okay. Legislator Amo on that motion.
No, I was going to raise the same question, Doug. I think that it's mathematically more correct if you go 10 to 19.
20 to 29.
No.
Why not?
No,
it's not. I have 9.9. Okay, I'm going to vote no then, because I think it's mathematically incorrect.
Okay, you want to say something else, Steve? And also, is this time sensitive, and it is? Because some employees, I think, want to retire within the next,
sure,
separate.
Just
right?
A couple points, and Sabina and I just chatted very quickly. You know, this is a negotiated item. It's a term and condition of employment, so the union needs to be on board. We did not change really any language in this from last year other than the terms of the dollar amounts. Last year, the language, and the year before, was exactly the same, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. You know, we're of the mindset that if you have 20 years on your anniversary, you're in a 20-year category. You have 19.99, you're in the 19 category. And again, we didn't have one issue with 191 employees for the last 2 years when we applied the same language to the last two incentives. As far as the timeline, it's been critical because it's part of the budget process now. It's really factored itself in to how the county exec determines the budget, which is due October 1st. Hence the reason why we schedule the date for the last separation is September 30th, and they have to let us know by September 1. So the county exec and the budget director can plan the budget accordingly. Those are the facts. We feel that it's worked. If any broke, don't fix it. Thank you.
So do we need this resolution that legislator Nagastakis made?
I do not believe so. In my opinion, we do.
Do you still want to move forward with it, legislator Nagastakis? For extra clarity, do you still want to move forward with that?
But look, I'm not going to argue that we did it before. I say it's incorrect. If a person's got 20 years, I don't know where he fits in. And if
all right, let's vote on
if
that,
some
then.
Different commissioner decides that he fits in the 10 to 20 to get only 10,000, then that would be a problem for that employee, potentially. So clarify it and correct it.
County attorney, you want to address your opinion on this?
Ultimately, this became a legal issue. Commissioner Gross would call me, I'm sure, for an interpretation.
Well, and as I read it, the word two is different than the word through. 10 to 20 years, to me, means up to 20 years. Then you got 20 to 30 means a minimum of 20 to 30 years. Then you hit 30 plus. So it's two is different than through. So I think the wording is correct as necessary. And quite frankly, if at the end of the day, somebody with exactly 20 wants to come and battle with us over the difference of the $2,500, Mr. Chairman, you're on the settlement committee. Mr. Benton, you're on the settlement committee. We'd settle the matter.
Okay.
Just point of information. Yes. I'm confused because both
clauses say two. They don't say through.
I think Mr. Nagas said 10 to 20 years, then for 20 to, so up to 20 is the maximum, 10 to 20, then starts at 20, gets more.
So if he's got 20, where does he fit?
If he gets 20, he's got 20, he gets 12.5.
Okay.
It's up to 20,
10 to 20, before 20, not through 20. Through would be exactly 365 times 20 plus the 5 leap years.
Okay. You still want to keep your motion or you want to remove it?
5 leap years, 5 leap years.
I mean, all right, I'll pull my motion.
Okay, seconder pulls the motion to him. Okay, now back to the...
In the interest of full disclosure, I have received telephone calls from department heads. They have had calls, and they've met with some employees wanting to know whether or not the voluntary separation agreement was going to go forward. I said it was up for a vote today. Some employees have already filed their retirement papers thinking this is going forward, but I'm just disclosing it so that, these are our county employees. I told them it would not, until it's voted on today, we didn't have a final decision, but some county employees have already put in their papers. I know for a fact some county employees pulled their papers so that they could take advantage of the separation agreement. So I'm just putting out that, not that it was, it's a wise thing to do, but I'm just letting you know that department heads have called me because they have, people are sort of pulling their papers, putting in their papers in reliance on this. Not that that's correct to do, but I just want to let the body know that that has in fact been happening.
It was mentioned it's time sensitive. So is it sensitive to 1 month? If it went back to committee for 1 month, what would be the results that would be consequential?
I mean, we're basically passing what we passed in the past. So, I mean, I don't know. Let's call the question here soon on the motion of question sent back to committee.
Yes.
Legislator Hines.
I'd request a caucus, please.
Okay, 5 minutes. Kelly, we back on? Okay, now we're on the discussion to send back to committee. Any further discussion? Roll call.
This is to send back to committee?
Yes.
Onasek?
No.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
No.
Anagnostakis?
No.
Benton?
No.
Berkman?
Yes.
Benelli?
No.
Cantorino?
No.
Cheney?
No.
Dillard?
Yes.
DeSalvo?
No.
Ekus?
Yes.
Fagione?
No.
Hines?
No.
Chemnitz?
Yes.
Kulisek?
Yes.
Paduk?
Yes.
Riskevich?
No.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Vero?
No.
Brescia?
No.
8 ayes, 13 noes.
Okay, now on the motion itself, any further discussion?
I do.
Yes.
If you look at the resolution, the second whereas says incentive to all county employees. But if you look at the voluntary separation overview, and this is what we had agreed on, it would be across all bargaining units. And so what I'd like to do in the resolution, in that second whereas, is after incentive to all, I would add union contract employees, county employees. That's one amendment.
Why don't we do these one at a time and make it easier, okay, where we can vote on them quickly? Okay. Is there a second to that motion?
So in the resolution...
Incentive to all county employees, right?
In the resolution it says to all county employees, but what we had discussed in committee and what's on this overview, it says only bargaining units, only employees in bargaining units. This would be applicable only to bargaining unit employees. So I'd like to make the amendments to add that.
Can I just make a statement with respect to that?
The reason why the first whereas clause states that it's been negotiated, because by state law, the county has to negotiate voluntary separation agreements with the collective bargaining units. That's why that is there. It's a statement of fact that they have been negotiated. Management has no ability to negotiate this, and there's no requirement under state law that it be negotiated. And so that's why that is stated in the first whereas clause. But the separation agreement incentive is offered to all county employees. It's just not negotiated with them. So that's the difference. So that's why the verbiage is different.
Barry, you have a question or a statement?
Yes. Just a kind of a correction, I guess. According to the legislative request form, which we received, it states very clearly that it's a request of authorization for voluntary separation agreement for all Orange County government employees. So I don't think there's a question there.
Okay, is the motion still on or is it gonna be removed? We did get a second, didn't we?
Yes, we did get a second. Thank you. I just wanna say this is messy then, okay? Because you have one thing, and you know what? Mr. Cheney, you're correct. It does say that on the request, but not on this quick study that was given at the committee.
Are you keeping the motion on or not?
No, I'll withdraw it.
Now your next amendment.
Now the next amendment is under the first resolve, where the first bullet point under the first resolve, where it says with 10 to 20 years, I'd like to add with 10 and up to 20 years.
Discussion. Roll call.
And the only reason, I believe in this, and I don't have a problem with the whole idea of the separation agreement, but the reason why I'm going with up to is I believe that Mr. Chapman, who was completely correct in his explanation, said up to each time he said it. So that's where I'd like to add it.
I don't think you need to do that, do you?
I'm just...
You have a microphone back there or not?
Maybe you need to get one.
Yeah.
I have a big mouth. Bottom line is I don't care. Up to and to means the same thing. So, I'm not an English teacher. I'll defer to Legislator Bonasek, but this is how I interpret it. And I think my interpretation is correct, and I didn't spend too much time...
Let's get roll call on this then.
There's a second part to that. Did you make that separate? And then the second part is 12,500 for 20 to 30, and add in the word up before 2:30. And by the way, I'm an English teacher too.
Okay. Roll call. Yep. Let's do this. Roll call.
I just don't have the second on that motion.
Okay.
I don't think. Okay. Thank you.
That was Chris.
Thank you.
Roll call.
Bonasek.
Is this to up to?
Yeah. Yes.
Yes. Up to.
No. Turnbull.
Yes.
Amo.
No.
Nagustakis.
Yes.
Benton.
Yeah.
Kirkman.
Yes.
Benelli. Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney?
No.
Dillard?
Yes.
DeSalvo?
No.
Ekus?
Yes.
Fagione?
No.
Hines? Chemnitz?
Yes.
Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich?
No.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Bureau?
No.
Brescia?
No.
14 I, 7 no's.
Okay, next. Is that it? Okay, now on resolution number 17, as amended. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yep.
Nagustakis? Benton? Berkman?
Yes.
Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia, 21 ayes.
And number 18.
Legislators Cheney, Fagione, DeSalvo, and Bonasek. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to reallocate confidential secretary to the county executive at the Orange County Executive's Office pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Bresha, 21 ayes.
Number 19.
Legislators Cantorino, Fagione, DeSalvo, and Hines. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to create assistant to the county clerk at the Orange County Clerk's Office pursuant to Section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion.
Right here?
Yes.
I just want to state that due to the what I stated before in regards to manipulating the desk audit, I will be voting no on this. Unfortunately, it has taken out the credibility of a desk audit for me.
Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
No.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Bresha. 19 ayes, 2 noes.
Okay, number 20.
Legislators Cantorino, Cheney, and Chemnitz. Resolution extending the benefit of time for the appointment of Darcy Miller to serve as Acting Commissioner of the Department of Mental Health for Orange County by the County Executive pursuant to Section 3.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Yes. Myrna. Okay. Add all Republicans. Michael. Okay. It can be added, yes. You want to say something too, right?
I think we discussed this in Human Services Committee, and I think the extension, we're all going to vote for it, I suspect, but the extension really is we're really close to having a very active discussion about the creation of the merger of the two departments with a super commissioner. We just need more time to do that. And I think we may be having it brought to our committee in July or August to have this discussion. So this is just an extension to, I mean, 18 months, but the reason is they were moving in the direction that we planned at the very beginning.
Okay, yes, Myrna.
I was looking forward to having a report already in because it was required. And barring a very detailed report, a statement that a report was in effect being created, even if it was just two columns. Because if you are doing two jobs and you want to combine them, and at least the way I would think about it, there would be a column of things that were easily done and a column of things that said, these need to be worked on. And then I would come to the committee because I had a report required on time and say, this is where I've gotten so far. And I will give you more specifics on the parts that need more identification. And perhaps together we could work out to see if it would really make a good fit, if you could dovetail it. I do not think that that would require another 18 months. I'm thinking more in terms of 6 months. So that's why I asked to have my name removed. And I don't know how to go about changing this to 6 months, but I just wanted you to know where I'm coming from on it. And it's not that I have anything to say that's negative, except if you have a commitment when you take a position and you're working toward filling the report commitment, and the way I would do it, I would show that I was on my way and I am having some trouble in this area or this is working.
Legislator Ekis and Legislator Turnbull.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I can't believe it was 18 months ago. It seems like yesterday that we did this. So I believe it shows how quickly this goes, time flies. I do believe that there was a request by the chairman to have a report. I believe we're going to get the report. And I don't have all the answers, but I can tell you this.
I have sat in meetings personally with Darcy Miller, and I can tell you that nothing but improvement has happened to the Department of Mental Health. And I understand why somebody might want to change the time frame, but I think Darcy deserves what she's earned, which is another 18 months. Should a report come out saying or stating otherwise, it might change my mind. But right now, I would like to back this. Mr. Chairman, I'd like to put my name on as a sponsor.
Bergman.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You know, my feeling is that the report was due. Since there is no report at this time or any partial report to submit, it's kind of a red flag, you know, that if somebody is so busy that they don't have time to do a report when due, are they really taking on too much? So I'm going to support this today. I think Darcy's a hard worker, but I'm going to be watching it closely to make sure this report comes due when she said, I believe, in June, July.
Okay, Legislator Anastakis.
Thank you again, Mr. Chairman. Just to put everyone at ease, Mr. Amel kind of hinted at it. Ms. Miller comes before both of our committees. She was supposed to give a report. She is preparing a report, my understanding is, a very detailed report on the consolidation, which was a couple of months off, and what Chairman Amel and myself decided, and we made it public to everyone in both committees, that she will be coming next month, which is the next round of committee meetings, for a joint session of our committees to give us a preview of the report. So we will have a preview report before the full report comes out. So we're working together to make sure that everybody knows where she stands and what she sees moving forward. But the executive and herself are putting together a full scale report that she will have, I guess, in a couple of months. Thank you.
Yes.
I would just like to say that one of the conditions of hiring was this full report, and it is something that we requested and both parties were aware of, and it didn't happen. And I think it's very nice that we're going to get a partial report next month and then a full report sometime in the future, but I think that we really need to be credible here. And when a deal is made. And I would like to be fair because I'd like to see this happen. So therefore, I'm throwing out a motion to change the 18 months until for 6 months. And I think that's pretty fair.
Is there a second? Okay, no second? Erna, okay, second. Yes, Barry.
I think one thing that has not been mentioned regarding the report and the subsequent state review that has to take place, 6 months may not be anywhere near enough. If we don't get the report and approve the report until September, and there's another 3 or 4 months that the state has to review it, and that's probably quick on their timetable. And so I think that the 18 months is an appropriate period given the circumstances. And I would just ask counsel what would happen to the position were we not to extend it?
Well, you'd have to look to see who the county executive would then designate as the acting commissioner. I'm not sure if there are deputy commissioners at the Department of Mental Health. They typically do become the acting when the commissioner is not. So as a default, he may in fact just place Ms. Miller as the acting commissioner until such time as an appointment is made.
Okay, let's call the question on the motion for 6 months. Roll call.
Bonasek?
No.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amel?
No.
Anagnostakis?
No.
Benton?
No.
Berkman? Benelli?
No.
Cantorino?
No.
Cheney? Dillard?
No.
DeSalvo?
No.
Ekus?
No.
Fagione?
No.
Hines?
No.
Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich?
No.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Vero?
No.
Brescia?
No. Okay, now roll.
Ayes, 15 noes.
Roll call on the, okay, question.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure that Mr. Anagostakis will agree with this, that maybe at our joint meeting, since there's so much misunderstanding about what the report looks like, when it was supposed to be done, let's open the, have our committee meeting. All legislators invited. Come listen to it. You know, come listen to it if you want to know what's going on. Love to have you.
Okay, roll call. Number 20.
Bonison?
Yes.
Turnbull? Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Benton?
Yes.
Berkman?
Yes.
Benelli?
Yes.
Cantorino?
Yes.
Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan?
No.
Vero?
Yes.
Brescia? 20 ayes, 1 no.
Okay, number 21.
Legislators Fagion, Cantorino, Amo, Ekis. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to create two autopsy assistant positions at the Orange County Department of Health pursuant to section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call. Yes.
Sorry. I don't want to lengthen the meeting, but I had very great misgivings until the ME came in and explained this to us, and I'm completely convinced that we need to change the classification of these positions. So I'm very much for it.
Okay, roll call.
Bonison?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 21 ayes.
Okay, number 22.
Legislators Fagion, Cantorino, Amo, and Ekis. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to create autopsy assistant per diem at the Orange County Department of Health pursuant to section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonisek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia. 21 ayes.
And number 23.
Legislators Fagion, Paduk, and Vero. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to reallocate offender services counselor at Orange County Office of the Sheriff Corrections Division pursuant to section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Aye.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonisek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney? Dillard? DeSalvo? Ekis? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Vero? Brescia? 21 ayes.
In there. 24? Yeah, Lee left. Okay, number 24.
Legislators Cantorino, Dillard, Fagion, and Vero. An act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to create offender services counselor at the Orange County Office of the Sheriff Corrections Division pursuant to section 2.021 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonisek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, Dillard, DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia. 20 ayes, 1 absent.
And number 25.
Legislators Dillard and Cantorino, an act amending the appropriate Orange County employment schedules to reallocate Executive Director, Orange County Human Rights Commission at the Orange County Human Rights Commission pursuant to section 2.02I of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Legislator Paduk.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just one question. I know we've had concerns about this position, whether we're hiring at grade 25 The range isn't listed on here anywhere. I think we talked about 75, then it was raised to 95. Do we know what the range is?
Up to 103,000.
And we're hiring at 95. And we've discussed this many times. We talked about how we're getting close to the caps for all the managers. We got to keep raising the caps. Well, then we shouldn't be hiring people that close to the cap, where all of a sudden now we're going to talk about raising caps. I've said it in committee, and I just wanted to mention it again today. I wasn't sure, and it is at 95, so we're off close to a 103 cap, I would say, to start out.
Legislator Bergman.
I assume that all of us have a shared commitment for human rights, and I think that we all, when we look at the Human Rights Commission here in Orange County, we would all support invigorating it. And I have had the honor of going to many, if not all, of the events since I've been an elected official. So I'm not in any way saying anything other than supportive in strengthening the commission. That being said, that's one wide range of discretion for hiring a new director, particularly when we haven't had one. But we need improvements, and with somebody at the helm, I'm sure the improvements will come. I just make the suggestion that it be closer to the $75,000 range, not including the cost of benefits. Because I think when you get $100,000 on a brand new employee, in other words, providing more money doesn't prove a greater commitment to human rights. But providing a fair wage to some new blood and new management over there, what I think would be a great benefit to all the people in the county. For that reason, I'll support it, but I just want to be on record as suggesting that a $75,000 range would be more appropriate.
Any other discussion?
Is it programmed at 95 right now?
Yes, Langdon.
The bottom line is, I believe the budget contained 95, but I'll tell you, I've had discussions with the county executive, and Mr. Berkman, I think you and he are pretty much of a similar mindset. I will tell you, ultimately, it's the commission's choice who to hire, and they actually will be setting the salary, but it's going to have to be within that range.
Agree with those sentiments, too. So.
You know, but the county executive happened to mention something very similar to what Mr. Berkman said.
Legislator Vero?
Are we able to make an amendment to reduce that amount from 95 to, say, 75 right now on the floor?
No.
It's a budget item, and it's a graded position. And the reality is you're already 4 or 5 months through the 5 months through the fiscal year already, so you're not going to spend that much this year. But, you know, I can just tell you, I know the county executive's line of thinking, although it is ultimately the commission's discretion, not with all respect to my boss.
Right. But the message is clear, and the county exec's on the same wavelength, so let's hopefully see some follow through on that.
And almost like you see it at a range up to 75,000.
Stuck on that up to language?
You like that up to.
Yes, Mike.
So that means actually the commission could hire him at 103.
They could hire him at 103, Mr. Kaluta, because they would be exceeding the appropriation under law.
I'm sorry, I'm not understanding.
Exceeding the appropriation under law.
We've only appropriated
95, so they can only hire on up to 95. Up to, keyword, up to. Two words, two. Thank you, Langdon. Can't slip anything by you. Okay. All right, are we ready for roll call? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Benelli? Cantorino? Cheney, Dillard, DeSavo, Ekus, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulwasek, Padoop, Riskevich, Sullivan, Bureau, Brescia. 20 ayes, 1 absent.
Okay, number 26. Does everybody want to be on that one?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, good. No? Is there a no over here? Oh, okay. You're a military guy. You better be on that. All right. I thought Matt said no. I was going to take it back, but all right. Read the resolution.
It's Sayers, Paduk, and Cheney. Resolution extending additional benefits to all employees of Orange County called to active military duty.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Berkman, Benelli, Cantorino, Cheney, Diller, DeSalvo, Ekis, Fagion, Hines, Kemnitz, Kulisek, Padu, Kriskevich, Sullivan, Vero, Brescia. 20 ayes.
Yes, oh, we forgot about, okay. Yes, I can. Okay, oh, we forgot to acknowledge Walt Corey, didn't we? Or is he going to be here next month? No? Yeah, Jim Kulisek, did you want to say, I thought somebody said you wanted to say something about Walt Corey? Just to recognize, yeah, I was sorry about that. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead, Jeff.
I think that he's a first-class public servant, and I appreciate all the service for the people of Orange County. He's been a class act and an example for all Orange County employees and legislators to follow.
You're here. I ditto that. Definitely a professional, exceptional commissioner. Okay. Motion to adjourn?
Second.
We're adjourned. Yeah.